Hi! In this video, we'll show you how to set up the members area on Tilda to create a membership website. With the members area, you can restrict access to specific pages, making sure only registered users can view exclusive content. It's perfect for internal knowledge bases, team-only resources, or premium content behind a sign-up wall. Let's explore how it works. Say you have a team knowledge base for your employees that compiles all the necessary company materials. Each department should have individual access to specific pages on the website that contain the relevant information. Let's see how we can set it up. To access the members area, go to Site Settings, Membership, and choose Manage Members. To grant access to internal pages, you'll first need to assign users to specific groups. There are a few ways to do this. One option is to add users manually by entering their email addresses. Let's try that. I'll click the Add New Member button and add our first employee, Alex, the designer. Below, you can choose how to set the password for each user. If the Generate a Password and Email it to the Member checkbox is enabled, a password will be automatically created and sent to the user via email. If you prefer to set a custom password manually, simply disable the checkbox and share the password directly with your employee or client. Once you save the changes, the user will receive an email with their login details and a link to access their account. You can also mass import users to a group. Click the three dots and select Import Members. Then, enter their contact info and names and click Import. If you don't have users' email addresses, or if you're expecting a large number of signups, there's a simpler option. You can copy a registration or login form, add it to your website, or share the link via a newsletter. Users will be able to register themselves and set their own passwords during the signup process. Additionally, you can create your own custom signup form using pre-designed blocks or create a custom form layout in ZeroBlock. You will learn how to set it up later in the video. Finally, you can enable paid registration, so your users will only access gated content once they have paid for it. We will dedicate a section of this tutorial to setting up paid memberships later in the video. I added the rest of the employees, so we can move on to the next step. Now let's see how you can organize members into groups to manage their access to specific content. In the left-hand panel, open Groups and click Create New Group, or simply hover over the section and click the plus icon that appears on hover. Groups allow you to easily manage user access. For example, I'm creating a group for people who need access to content on marketing and design, so I'll name the group accordingly. Once the group is created, you'll see a login link. This is where users will enter their username and password to access the content. Here, you'll also find a registration page, which is handy if you want users to sign up on their own and automatically gain access to the group's pages. Now, let's open the Pages tab. Here, you can preview all pages available on your website. If you are still in the process of adding new pages, you can return to this step later. Once the pages are added to your website, the list will update automatically. I want to grant access exclusively to marketing managers and designers, so I'll make the Marketing Resources and Design Resources pages available to that group. Other employees won't have access to these pages. Additionally, I'll provide access to Staff Directory page with employee birthdays and contact details. This page will be hidden from external visitors, but accessible to the entire team. All right, let's go back to the Members tab. Here, you'll see all registered members, whether they signed up via the registration form or were added manually. You can include or exclude members from a group by changing their status in the table or via the Members Credentials pop-up, which opens when you click a user's name. The Members Credentials window lets you view their contact details, group memberships, activity status, statistics, and notifications. You can also assign a user as a tutor. It's a helpful option if you plan to integrate courses within the Members area. To learn more about creating online courses on Tilda, check out the guide in the description. In this example, I want to grant access to a designer, a marketing manager, and the head of the department, so I'll include them in the group. Similarly, I've created a separate group for the legal department and added the legal team accordingly. Let's see what it looks like from the user's perspective. Head over to the registration page and log in. Now, we can see the page this user has access to. If you click the profile icon, you'll see a list of all the groups available to you. If you belong to multiple groups, they'll all be listed here. You can notice that after logging into your account, we see a default page. However, it doesn't show all available content. To ensure smooth and intuitive navigation, I want to set up an index page that guides users to the sections they need. You can create this page using a pre-designed template or build it from scratch. In my case, I've already prepared one with a welcome message, links to key pages, information about company, and a feedback form. Next, I'll make sure to add the new page to the Marketing and Design group. Now, let's go to Group Settings. Here, you can select an index page from the drop-down list. This is the page users will see first after logging in. I'll choose the index page I've just added. If you don't specify an index page, the first page from the list of included pages will be displayed by default. Now that we've set the index page, let's see how it works for the Marketing and Design group. After logging in, you'll see the index page with all the essential navigation links, allowing users to easily access other pages. Back in the group settings, you can also manage the group's access period, setting it to unlimited for a specific period or until a selected date. For example, you're planning a team meetup in November. You can create a form to collect employee availability, ideas for the event, or general feedback. Choose until the date selected and set it to September 10th. This gives you enough time to prepare ahead of the event. Be sure to mention the access deadline in the form when collecting feedback. Keep in mind, if you don't check the Apply to All Members box, the new access period will only apply to new members. Existing members will retain their original access settings. To allow users to join this group automatically, check the option Approve Membership Requests Without Confirmation. If this box is unchecked, you'll receive a membership request after a user registers, and you'll need to approve it manually. You can also specify an expected payment for automatic group entry. If access to the group is paid, enter the required amount in this field. Payment is automatically verified, and if the amount is less than specified, the user won't be added to the group. In our case, participation in the team event is free, so I'll leave this field blank. Let's save the changes and move on. Now let's take a look at what we can customize in the members area settings. Here, you can upload a logo that will appear on the login and registration pages and allow or restrict self-registration through the form. Under the Advanced tab, you'll find more settings, including options for customizing the design of the page. Let's go ahead and start with the profile button icon settings. Here, you can set the profile button width as well as vertical and horizontal offset values, both for mobile and desktop. This will add the distance between the profile button and its positioning point on the screen. Under Positioning, you change where the profile button will appear on the screen. For example, if you'd like the profile button to be positioned on the top left instead of the top right, select Top Left, save your changes, and refresh the page. Now the icon appears on the left, and the offset will be applied relative to this new position. I prefer it to be placed on the right, so I'll reset it to Top Right. Next, I'll change the background color to blue and set the opacity to 100%. You can also adjust border width and color for the button and for the icon inside it right here. If you change your mind, you can always reset the values by clicking the Reset to Default button. Let's save the changes and move on to the login and sign up page settings. Here, you can choose the form style, centered or two column, and adjust additional settings like form width, alignment, and offset. If you select the two-column form style, extra options will appear, a slider to set column width and the form position, left or right. Let's switch back to the centered form style. Here, you can specify the form width. I'll set it to 500 pixels. Next, you can adjust the form's alignment within the browser window, input alignment inside the form, as well as horizontal and vertical offset, form background shadow color, and form background border radius. Now, if your website includes any form that collects personal data, like names or contact info, that counts as personal data processing. In that case, users must give consent to store and use their information. Under the form, I'll add a privacy policy agreement text and include a link to the policy. Next, let's add some visuals. Here, you can upload a background image for the page and the form, set a gradient, adjust opacity, or turn the image into a pattern by checking the box. In the typography settings, you can customize the font color and size for the title, the text under the signup form, and the signup form link. In the form input style settings, you can adjust the color and font weight of the input title, input text, and placeholder. You can also customize the background, icons, and border settings. Finally, in the button settings, you can style the login and register buttons, including text color, background, and borders for both default and hover states. Let's save the changes and see how our form turned out. The form now has a background image and a privacy policy text displayed below. In addition to the registration form from the members area we've just set up, you can also build your own custom form to register users. How to set it up? Let's go to the page editor. Here, I've added the BF403 block and updated the text. You can choose any suitable block from the block library or build your own using ZeroBlock. In order to connect Members Area to your form, go to Site Settings, Forms. From the list of data collection services, select Members Area, then choose the group you need from the dropdown. I'll select the Fall 2025 Meetup group I created for the corporate event. Now, let's go back to the page editor with your form. Access the Content tab of the block and connect Members Area under Data Collection Services to receive users' data. A step-by-step guide is available in the Help Center. The link is in the description. Now, anyone who fills out this form will be added to the Members Area system and placed in the Fall 2025 Meetup group, automatically receiving an email with their password and login link. Now, let's explore some more advanced settings in the Members Area. Under Start Page Settings, you can adjust font and container parameters and upload an image for the start page. Additionally, you can specify text above the container and text under the container. For example, you might include a welcome message, highlight something important, or provide contact details for the group admin or support team. In the project settings, you can specify an email address, phone number, and name. These will appear in automatic messages sent to users. Below, you can also add a header and footer to the page. To send emails, you'll need a mail server. To set it up, go to Mail Server Settings. By default, the email delivery service is set to Standard, but if you expect to handle more than 500 registrations per hour, it's recommended to set up your own mail server by choosing it in the dropdown and specifying the outgoing mail server address, port, connection security type, and more. In the email settings, you can choose the language used in email notifications, such as password change messages or group join alerts. By default, it's set to your website's language, but you can change it and customize the message. All right, and that's it. Your company's members area is ready to go. How do you set up paid access to a group? Say you have a landing page where you're selling a digital product, for example, a workshop on watercolor painting. You want users to gain access to a page with the video, a list of materials, and other resources after they complete their payment. Let's walk through how to set it up. I've already prepared two pages, one for the payment process and one with the masterclass content. Now, I'll go to the members area and create a group called Watercolor. Under Pages, I'll select the page the user should access after payment. In this case, Painting Workshop. Next, I'll open the group settings. Since I want users to get access automatically after payment, I'll check the box for Approve Membership Requests Without Confirmation under Member Sign Up. Then, I'll set the expected payment for automatic entry to $40. The members area is ready. Now let's set up the cart and data collection service. Go to Site Settings, Forms, Members Area. Here, select the group you want users to be added to. I'll choose Watercolor and click Add. If you want all forms on your website to send data to this group, click Assign Service to All Forms on the website. In my case, I don't need that. Next, go to the Payment Systems and add the payment method that works best for you. You'll find a detailed guide on connecting payment systems in the description. Now, let's open the page where users will complete their purchase. We need to add the ST100 block with the shopping cart from the block library to let users place their orders. If you're using blocks from the store category to sell access to your product, the cart will be connected by default. In my case, I'm using a regular button block from the button category, so I need to link it to the cart manually. To do this, open the ST100 block content tab and copy the link format, hashtag order, product name equals price. Then paste that link in the content tab of the block with the button promoting the product. I'll change the product name to workshop and the price to 40. Let's save the changes and go back to the shopping cart block content tab. Make sure that the box under connected services is checked for the correct members area group and add any other integrations you may need, like a CRM. Save the settings and publish the page. Now, after a successful payment, it will be automatically added to the selected members area group and will receive access to the product page. We've covered the key settings of the members area and how to put them into practice. This tool is incredibly flexible and works for a wide range of uses, from building employee databases and managing access to corporate events, selling digital products and gated content, and more. If you want to explore further, check out the detailed guide on setting up and using the members area in the Tilda Help Center. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your projects.